So, it's you. How did you get here and what do you want? I'll do a swap with you. I'll light the candle in your ice crystal chandelier if you will set my brother free.
The Snow Queen's frosty forehead furrowed into a worried frown as she thought for a while.
All right, I'll do that.
She's lying. Don't trust her,
whispered the bee.
We'll see, whispered Jonaback.
The Snow Queen seemed very sure of herself in her white fur coat as she smiled like the Cheshire Cat.
Light my candle and I'll call for your brother.
Jonna struck a match and gave it to the bee, which held the flickering flame between its feet and flew towards the last candle to have gone out. But when it had got halfway up in the air, the bee lost its hold on the burning match. It came floating down and landed in the Snow Queen's lap. Her winter fur coat caught fire and burst into flames. And soon the whole of the Snow Queen was ablaze.
Oh my goodness, we must put the fire out and save her. Quick, shouted Jonna.
But before anyone was able to think any further, the fire went out on its own. A little river of water ran down from the Snow Queen's fur coat, and she was no longer to be seen.
It wasn't just her heart that was made of ice. The whole of her was,
said the bee, setting down on Jonna's shoulder.
Yes, that really does seem to have been the case, said Jonna sadly.
She couldn't understand why evil creatures had to exist who ended up destroying themselves. John had seen the fire burning and came running into the hall together with the flying swarms of bees. The twins couldn't stop hugging each other tight.
I didn't know whether you were still alive, John. I was. And how lucky it was that you found me. Thanks, Jonna, for saving my life.